Beginning our daf Masechet Pesachim, daf Kuf Yud Ches. We begin on the bottom line of Kuf Yud Zayin of Beis, where we continue to explain Allah in the previous Mishnah regarding the last two cups of wine. Hashem Kuzman because of Ches the Tehinda of Chaim Pesachim is joining us today's daf. As we said, the Mishnah discusses the third and fourth cups of wine of the Seder night. Over the fourth cup, we also recite Halal Gadol, which is Tehillim Perek Kol HaMidvav, which has 26 verses of Ki Le'olam Chazdei. The Gemara brings several lessons about Hashem providing sustenance, panasa, and the question of once we have Halal Gadol, which the Gemara says is such a great halal, it's called Halal Gadol, why do we say the regular halal on each Yomtim, which, if we could say the Halal Gadol. The Gemara elaborates on the salvation of Chanan Mishra Bazari from Kifshin Aish and the downfall of Sisra. The Gemara concludes the Darshan of Sukkim from Halal. So the key term of the concept is that HaKadosh Baruch Hu in Kabetz Chabekolberi, HaKadosh Baruch Hu does not hold back the reward of any creation, everyone gets what's coming to them. Now, we said on the previous stuff that you pour the third cup, you make benching. Like we said, it doesn't prove the benching requires a cup. It's only tonight that we have four cups anyway, so we do a mitzvah with each one. Then, as our Gemara continues, said, Revi, the fourth cup of wine, going well over the halal, we conclude the halal, which we start already in Magid, which we started the halal, which Machlik Hashem itself, you say one or two prokem of the halal. Vamelo Birchas Hashem, you say the bracha of the song. So we can't connect up with Kofi Tchas Madam. The Gemara asks, my Birchas Hashem, what is this song, this blessing of the song that we say by the Seder night? So Yudami says, this is by the Halal, we say Yahalalucha, they shall praise you, Hashem Lekein Hashem our God, and we conclude, Baruch Atah Hashem Melech Mehula Bat Tishpachis, like we say by Halal, which that's what the Mishnah means when it says you make a Birchas Hashir, which is a Birchas Hashavach, a praise of Hashem. Rabbi Yechemi says, means Nishmas Kolchai, which Rashbam explains to me, say, we also say Nishmas. And when the Mishnah says we say Birchas Hashir, it refers to Nishmas because, as Rashbam explains, if you would say it means Yahalucha, we say that every time we say Hal. So what would be the uniqueness of Pesach that we're saying that, oh, when you say this Birchas Hashir, obviously it's coming to include another bracha, which is, usually when we say Hal, we don't say Nishmas. Here by Hal, we say, besides the ending bracha, we also say Nishmas. So that's the two different opinions about what's this Birchas Hashir. Now, tell me when the Brisa Revi, the fourth cup of wine of the Seder night, Gemel was a Hal, you could call the Hal. And you say the great Halal, which is basically Perek Kof Lamed Vav, and the Gemara doesn't explain exactly where it is. That's the Rib Tarfon. Now, B'yeshem, some say that actually you say Perek Kof Gimel in Tehillim, which is Hashem Roi, Hashem is my shepherd, Lo Yechzer, I will not be lacking, which is because of the food that he ate before this Halal. So therefore you have to say here by the fourth cup of wine, this Perek in Tehillim. Now, going back to the first opinion, it says Gemara Mechan Halal Gadol. From where is the Halal Gadol? Which parts of Tehillim does it include? Shav Yudami says Mihaydu Adnaras Bubble, which is basically Perek Kuf Lamed Vav. That is how we do it, and that's the Halal Gadol. Rav Yechanan he says Mishir Hamalas. It actually starts in Perek Kuf Lamed Dalad Adnaras Bubble until Naras Bubble, not including Naras Bubble. That's what encompasses the Halal Gadol. Rav Yaakov he says it's Michiyakun Bochaloi Kof, which actually is in the middle of Kof Lamed Hey, Pasik Dalin, Adnar's Bubble. So again, it's they're all approximately in Kof Lamed Bubble. The question is, does it start in the middle of Kof Lamed Hey, or does it actually start with Kof Lamed Dalin? Now, Balamed Gushma Halgadol, why was it called the Great Hal? So, Mirichin, this isn't Nishak Kadiz Bochal, Yishabir Mishalim, because God is sitting there on the heights of the world, Machal Gmizan Zal Beria, and he gives out food for every creature, like it says in the Pasik Nisan Lechem Machal Basar. Which you usually have kavana by that one, kilon chazam, that one, that's the great thing. What makes the halal gadol is because Hashem gives bread to every living creature. So if you want to have kavana, that's really definitely the one that makes the halal gadol. Any creature Hashem gives food, and that's what's called halal gadol. Am Shmuel Levi says, now, hani esem meshisha haydu. This way you say, you say, connected me, who are you saying this 26 times kilon chazam? It's connected chavav darish, shabar kadosh baruch hu b'lamed. And we say this every Shabbos morning, we say this not the Halal Gadol. We say there's 26 generations that HaKadosh Baruch Hu created in his world. And that's why Ki Le'olam Chazdai could either mean everlasting or Ki Le'olam for the world is Chazdai. But in his world, there were 26 generations. B'Le'olam Shel Torah. The Torah was only given 26 generations into the creation of the world. Because for the world, 26 generations, he only sustained, because the world is not fit to be sustained without the Torah. And his kindness, his infinite kindness, is why he's sustained. And that's why he says 26 times this 26 generations of the Torah that he sustained the world with his kindness. Amar of Chizda now, another interesting idea. Magdik said, what does it mean? Hoidu Lashem, give thanks to Hashem, ki toiv, because he's good. And then I say, Kila Oilam Chazdei. What does that mean, Kitoi? So, Hoidu Lashem, give thanks to Hashem, Shagoy Vachay Vasa Shalavah Mitoy Vasai. You know what he collects from the person that owes him? It's with his own good that he gave to the person. So the way you have to understand the pasuk is ki toiv ki la'olam chazed, meaning it's a chesed that Hashem does for the world with his good, with ki toiv. In other words, with the goodness that he did, that's his kindness. With that the toiv that he gave ki toiv ha'ik la'Hashem, give thanks to Hashem. Why ki toiv? Because the goodness that he gave you ki la'olam chazed is part of his chesed. Because as the Gemara explains, asher b'shayri, Hashem wants to punish somebody. So what he does is he gives him a heshefah and bracha, he gives him an ox, and then the guy loses his ox. On the b'seyah, or pauper with his lamb, or yosam b'bitzasay, or the orphan with his eggs, or amon b'tana galusa, or a widow with her hen. Meaning he makes the person lose the money, and that atones for the person's body. So it's kitayiv kilam chazi. Hashem, his chesed is for the world, is that it's kitoy. He collects from the goodness that he gave you. So you're not going to get, he's giving you more so that you can lose that. You say, oh, yeah, I lost that. You should bench Hashem for that, because really it was going to come to you in the body, but that's the kindness of Hashem. Now, continuing on this idea now, once we're speaking about a person's sustenance, that we said that what makes it halal gadol is like a Kachbo who gives food, mezainis l'chol beria. So that's for the animal kingdom. But Rami Yochanan says, Kashim is Ainas of Shalabdom. And you see the Diyuk of Shalabdom, how difficult it is, the Parnasa for a person is Kiflaim Kiyaleder. It's double the pains of childbirth. The Ilubi Yaleder said, whereas by childbirth it says, Be'etzev with suffering, you're going to give birth. Uve Mezainais, and by sustenance, it says, Be'itzavayim, which is like a double, in a double pain. So as difficult as childbirth, tell the wife, hey, I go out to work. But the panos is as double as difficult, as painful as it is of childbirth. Amar Yechon says, "Kashim is enoch shalom," that it's difficult the panos of a person. Yishim ha'gula more than the redemption, because the Ilu Gula said regarding being redeemed, it's the famous panos says, "Hamal ha'goy l'shim kara," the angel that redeemed me from all bad, Malch Malma, just a regular angel. Vilma Zayin says, but regarding sustenance, it says, "Ho'alekim ha'royoy," see, the God that shepherds me. So you see how difficult it is to have panos. Hashem himself has to do it. It's not even enough with a mouth. Amar Shuma Levi, continuing on this curse of Be'itzavim, which we said how difficult it is to get parnasa. So that relates to the original curse. B'shoshem HaKadosh Baruch Hu Adam. When HaKadosh Baruch Hu told to Adam HaRishon, B'koitz V'darda Tatzmeach Lach, oh, you already, the earth is cursed because of you. You sin with the Eitz Hadas. So thorns and thistles will sprout for you, means to say you're gonna have to work the land. So Zolgain of the mice. So the eyes of Adam started streaming tears. Me and my donkey were gonna be eating in the same trough, like that's said working the land. I used to get mund or whatever from the shahabar, Ali get the zakh, and now I'm gonna be eating from the ground with the donkey. But once he was told, with the sweat of your brow, you're going to eat bread. Oh, and the scarlet has calmed down. Means that we don't eat just the grain from the ground like the Bahamas. We turn it into bread, and therefore that's a more elevated status of a human being. Now, Amr Shum Malakash, she says a very interesting comment. He says, Ashreinu, we would have been good if we would have stayed with the first situation, meaning because grass is actually more found, it's easier found to eat like the grass, like the kid does, like the cow does, than to actually make panasa. So in other words, as much as that was a curse, it's easy. Behemoth just goes out and they find stuff all over. You get to eat some acorns, right? But we have to, until we make panasa, it's so difficult that it wouldn't have been such a bad thing. And it says the Gemara actually, but we're actually not saved from the original curse. Because the chlin is the dabra. We eat a meal, we give us greens from the earth, from the forest. What are we eating here? This is for animals. Right? Eat meat. We're carnivores. But we have a salad now. But Shabbos meal, they're serving a salad. We still have the same curse as eating from the same trough as the animals. Now, Amr Shizvi, Mishmeid, Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah says, Kashim Zaina Shaladim, it's more harsh, it's difficult, the sustenance of a person, Kikriyas Yamsev, like the splitting of the sea. Now, what does that mean, difficult? It means, as great as a miracle God did for the Jewish people when he split the Yamsev for them, That's how great is the miracle HaKadosh Baruch Hu does for someone that gives him parnasa. Now, what's the relevancy of this? Rashi says, L'mivi rachmi. Rashbam says, to beseech mercy. Because it's a great miracle. You got to really, just like by the Yamsuf, they were davening to Hashem and said, don't worry, just jump in, whatever. That's the same thing. When the person parnasa is as difficult, you really have to daven. So like it says in the Pasuk, over there in Halal Gadol, it says, Noisim lechem chol baso, kilo el mechazeh, Hashem gives meat, gives bread to every flesh, to every creature. But Samachlein, what's right there, it says, L'goyze Yamsuf dam kilo el mechazeh. Hashem split the sea into different parts. So you see, the Yamsuf is compared to a person's parnasa. Amalaz ben Azai says, Kashim nekav shalom. It's difficult a person's orifices, his where he excretes, his waste when it's clogged up, when it's constipated, kiyama misa, like the day of death, ukukris yamsif, and it's as difficult as the yamsif when it has to be opened up, that to open up those pipes, to that's how difficult it is. How do you see this? Like it says the pasuk in Yeshaya, it says mihar tsaya. Tsaya, Rashbam actually brings it means like of closed up, not tsaya as an excrement with an aleph, but here's with an ayin. It quickly open up that which is clogged. Mi'ar tsaya, that which is clogged up, it's quickly pasech to open up. Uksib basrei, which this is the idea of being able to relieve oneself after one was constipated. Uksib basrei, once say after that, roige hayam, the sea split, the yemu galov, and the waves raged, which that's like kriyas yamsiv. So you see the idea of kriyas yamsiv. Now, actually, the pasuk continues over there, below yomas l'shachas. He won't die to destruction. So you see, it mentions death there too. So you see that the inability to go to the bathroom is as difficult as a day of death and as relieving as kriyas yamsiv. Another teaching, we say a few teachings from Elazar ben Azariah. Rav Sheshem from Elazar ben Azariah says, called mavazes hamoyaves. Whoever degrades the yom tivim, meaning that he does malacha chal shamayit, which he's not supposed to. There are certain works you could do, but those which are forbidden. Kilo benavetzav to be worshipped idolatry. Shemayit says the pasuk in Shemayit. Elohei masechel esas. Look, don't make a molten image of a deity for you, which I would desire. Uksiv asher says after that eskaga matzah tishmar, that you should safeguard the yom tiv of Pesach, which the Gemara chagiga that the chesam alaf learns from there. This of doing malacha chal shamayit. So you see that doing malacha chal shamayit is like worshipping avodah zarah. Another teacher, Rav Sheshem from Elazar ben Azariah, is called Masab Lashon Hara. Whoever says over Lashon Hara, b'chol mekabel lashon, whoever receives slander, and b'chol made aid shekel b'chaviv, someone says false testimony on his friend, bro l'shlich l'klavim, is fit to be thrown to the dogs, because all these three things are learned to Hashem from the same pasuk in Shemais. Like kelet l'shlich l'mais, it says to the dog you should throw it. Now that's talking about an avela. But what does it say right after throwing to the dogs? Simbasri, it says, l'sis l'shem hashav, do not accept a report in vain, or a vain report. Now, someone who receives Lashon Hara is accepting and trusting his friend. Now, Rashbam points out, although you're not supposed to accept what he's saying as truth, you are supposed to be concerned for what he's saying. As the Gemara says, Nidav Samachal from Manal, what's called to be Mechish, but you're not supposed to accept. So you see, you're not, but accepting slander, which is Mekabel Lashon Hara, is accepting a Shem Hashav. Now, additionally, Bekari Be Leisasi, you also could read it as not Leisisa, but Leisasi, which means not to cause someone else to receive, which is the one who's saying over something that's wrong, of saying over Lashon Hara or Eidus Sheker, which Rashbam says not to be gurus, that because actually all of them are learned from Lisisa, not to carry, because when you tell or testify, you're carrying in your mouth a false report. So you're also carrying it. So you don't say Lisasi, it could even be Lisisa. Even the Lisisa, not accepting Lashon Hara, in the same word leisisa, you could also say about saying over Lashon Hara, because you're being makabel in your mouth when you're saying it over the Eidus Sheker b'chaveiro and regarding Lashon Hara. Now the Gemara goes back to the idea we mentioned before. Wait a second. Chima achadika halal gadol. So if you tell me that this great halal, which is perikov lam involved in tail, which is the kilo elam chazdi gid mechadim chazdi, which is so great, like Rabbi Yehuda said before, because says nois lechem uchal basa, which is such a great thing that Hashem gives bread to every creature. That's amazing that every creature somehow gets its parnasa. So why do we say on this halil on every single time of tzara or yom tov we say that when we redeem we say our regular halil? Why don't we say halal gadol? The Gemara has a few different interpretations. One, the Mishmashiyesh behid dvar malol, because our regular halil has these five things which also talk about redemption: Yitzis Mitzrayim, leaving Egypt, Kriyas Yamsuf, splitting the sea, Matan Torah, the giving of the Torah, Tchias Hameisim, the revival of the dead, Mechelas Shemashiach, and regarding the travails of Mashiach is coming. When we see these five things in Hal, Yitzis Mitzrayim, that's the Betzeis of Mitzrayim, when the Jewish people left Egypt. Kriyas Yamsuf, that's like it says, Hayom Rabbi, on the sea, so on it split. Matan Torah Nesavim says, Aharim Rok Tocha'el, that the mountains, they dance like hinds, like these animals, which was during when the Torah was given, like a pasuk in Talmud Samaches, Lama Teratz and Harm, why are the mountains dancing? Tchir Samation Nesavim says, As Halach Lofnei Hashem, I'm going to go in front of Hashem, Ba'eretz HaChayim, which is in the land of the future, Tchir Samation, Achem Hashem Mashiach, we're going to say the travails of Mashiach, like he said, Loilon Hashem, not for us, Hashem Loilon, not for us. Which Rabbi Bichon says, Leilon Hashem Leilonu, Zushibu Malchias, it refers to the servitude of the kings, which is before Mashiach comes, which is the Chavash of Mashiach. So you see, it alludes to these five things, and that's why we say it when we're saved from the Tsar. Now, I get down, they'll say, Rabbi Bichon, he says it different, Leilon Hashem Leilonu, that means to say, Zumachem is Gagumagi, that's the apocalypse. Chum of Gagumagi, that's the Chavash of Mashiach, not for us, not for us. Again, actually, even on later stage, not Shibu Malchias itself. And again, those are the five things. Another interpretation, the reason why we say our hal, not hal and gal, is because it talks about the saving of the souls of the righteous from Gehenna. Because it says in the pasuk, Ana Hashem, please Hashem, malta nafshi, save my soul, which is being saved from Gehenna. Because it refers to the descent of the righteous into the fiery furnace. And they're saving from it, and therefore we would prefer to say that when we have to say hal from save from Mitzar. We do say this. Who says this? Amar Chananya. Chananya said those words, not for us, Hashem, not for Hashem, when we're being thrown into the fire by Nebuchadnezzar. When the pasuk continues, because for your name give honor, Amar Mishal. Mishal said that. Al Chazuk Amar Mitecha, because of your kindness, because of your truth, Amar Azariah, that was the famous Chananya Mishal Azariah, who they were thrown into the fire. Each one said a different verse. And Lama Yamar Goyim, why should the nation say what they're saying? Amar Kulam, they all said together. Now, so that talks about their going into the fire. Al Yas Mikeshen, we're talking about them coming out of the fire. Like it says, Halu et Hashem Kol Gan. Later on, we say in the Hal, praise Hashem, all the nations. Am Chanani said that. Shabchu Kalumim, all the nations should praise him. Am Mishal said that. Kigabal in Chazde, because his kindness overpowered us. Am Azariah said that. Am Mishal Loyim Haluka, and the truth of God is forever. Praise him. Am Rukul Nail said that together. Now, but Yeshayim, however, there are some who say that the Eres Hashem Loyim, that part of the Hal, that the truth of God is eternal, Gabriel Amri, the Malach Gabriel, he said it when he saved Chananya Mishal Azariah, and he was there too, like the pasuk in Daniel, that Beriva Diriva Dami Labar Lehem, the fourth person, but they seemed like a man of God, because actually there was an angel over there, which was Gabriel, besides Chananya Mishal Azariah, and because HaKadosh Baruch Hu guaranteed Gabriel, as the Gemara is going to tell us, when they tried to save Avram by Urkazdim, when it was fulfilled, as we'll see in the Mabez, then Gabriel said, "Oh, Hashem says Shalom. Hashem kept His word that He let me save Chananya Mishal Azariah." As the Gemara explains, "V'shoshi ibul Nimrod harashas Avraham Avinu l'tor kibshon ha'esh." The famous story with the Nimrod, the wicked one, he went and threw Avraham Avinu into the fiery furnace. And actually, that's why in the Torah Nimrod is called Amraphel, because Amr Pul, he said that to throw Avraham Avinu into the fiery furnace. So Amr Gabriel says, "Of Nekadosh Baruch Hu, remember Hashem like this. Your bunch of master will erid betan ve'atzlat asetam kibshon ha'esh." Says, I'm going to go down, and I'm going to cool down, and I'm going to save the righteous person from the fiery furnace. So I'm like, Kadosh Baruch Hu said to him, Ani Yochid Ba'alom. He says, no, I'm the only one in my world. Bu Yochid Ba'alom, and Avraham Avinu was the only one in his world. He was the only one that preached monotheism. He was the only one. He was a Yochid. No, Yochid, that's a Yochid. It's appropriate for the individual to save the individual. So I'm going to save him. Now, Lafisha Kadosh Baruch Hu, in Kapi Eschar Karbel, but since God does not hold back the reward of any creature, so here he is, Gabriel trying to do a good deed. So Amar, he said, don't worry, Tizkir B'tatzal Shleishim in Nebundim, you're going to merit and you're going to save three of his grandchildren. Now, related, Dorish Reb Shimon HaShalom, he says, B'shah Shem Nebuchadnezzar, Rasha, Chanan B'shah Nezara, Tadatev Kish Na'esh. At that moment, when Nebuchadnezzar threw in these three great prophets, Chanan B'shah Nezara, into the fiery furnace, Amar Yurkamai Shal Sar HaBar, Lefnei Kadosh Baruch Hu, so Yurkamai, who, he was the minister of Hail, he stood in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Amar Lefnei, he said in front of Hashem, Rebbein Shalom, Master World. Erid Vatan, like Kirshna says, I'm going to go and I'm going to cool down the fiery furnace because I'm hail, I'm cold, and I'll take care of the heat. Va'atzal et tzaddikim al mikirshna, and I'm going to save the righteous from this fiery furnace. I'm like Gabriel, so Gabriel said to him, no, inkarash HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that's not the might of HaKadosh Baruch Hu like this. Sha'at Sar Bar, you're the angel of hail. Everyone knows that why water extinguishes a fire. El ani sar shel esh, I'm the minister of fire. I'm going to go, I'm going to cool down on the inside, and I'm going to heat it up from the outside, which actually to burn those who were throwing them into the fire, as actually the pasuk says in Daniel, that the men who threw them into the fire, actually they were killed in the fire, and I'll do a miracle within a miracle. which I don't know if this is taken away from the miracle, but I was on the phone with someone just literally moments before, and he told me the way he understands the pshat is, how do you understand a heat machine? When you do air conditioning or heat machine, the way it works, if you go on the other side, it actually, on the other side of the air conditioner, is usually hot. A heat machine, the other side is actually usually cold. So how does it work scientifically? It removes the heat. So that's what Gabriel, he was like, I'm fire. What I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the fire from inside. I'm going to take it outside. So it's going to actually cool down the inside. And actually the other side is going to get hot. I don't know if that's trying to rationalize miracles. But that's that. Akabam Gabriel said, I'm going to make a miracle within the miracle. I'm going to cool it down. And I'm like, hooray. Kadosh Baruch Hu said, yes, go down. Ah, but he said, Shabbat Shalom, Gabriel. But at that moment, Gabriel opened up and he said, the emes Hashem la'olam, the truth of Hashem is eternal, because Hashem, I was really trying to save my Avraham Avinu Baruch Hu, but Hashem promised me I'll get them there. And Hashem kept his word that I was able to save them. Now, a third interpretation, actually, Reb Nosson, he says, no, the emes Hashem la'olam, who said the truth of God is eternal, is Dogam Shebeyamamu, the fish in the sea, they said it. Why? What is the fish in the sea saying it? Because Rav Huna, he said, Yisrael Shebeis Adar, the Jews in that generation, by Yitzis and Tzayim, they were from the small faith people. They didn't have such big emunah. That they rebelled by the sea, by the Yamsa. What does that mean, the Jews rebelled? Yeah, the Jewish people rebelled at that time by Kriyas Yamsa, the greatest miracle of all time. They said, just like we came out on one side, maybe the Egyptians came on the other side. So I'm like, so that was the Mekat Neman. What is it? You see the greatest miracle of all time, and this is what you're asking? So my Kadosh Baruch Hu says, "Shiyam." So Kadosh Baruch Hu said to the angel of the sea, "Palatasim liyabasham, spit out the Egyptians onto dry land." Which actually, Rashbam points out that therefore the Egyptians merit to be buried on dry land, and that was in the merit that they said, "Ki Hashem nilchem lehem b'Mitzrayim." Oy, let's get out of here, because this is the God that fought for them in Egypt, which is their admitting to the might of God, and that merit they get merited to be buried, and that's actually what it means. Az Yashan Natisa Yamincha. You stretched out your right hand, Tivlei Ema Aretz, the earth swallowed them up, meaning Hashem swore to the ground, that's Natisi Yemincha, you stretch out your right hand as an oath, Tivlei Ema Aretz, then the earth swallowed up to promise the land, that don't worry, you're not going to get punished for burying the Egyptians. So that's what that pasuk means in Naz Yashan. Now, but I'm a lefanda, but this is what Hashem wanted from the sea, spit him out onto dry land. So the sea said, Ribbono Shel Olam, master of the world, Klum Yesh Evet Shenayis L'Rabbi Matana, is there such a thing that a servant, his master gives him a gift? When you gave all this sustenance for the fish, the aquatic kingdom is going to have a feast of all these people, of the Egyptians that fell in there. It takes away. You gave me all this food, you gave me this grace for Shalach Mundus. He said, oh, I'm sorry, I need it back after use it for someone else. So Hashem said, don't worry, I'm going to give you 150% back on your money. I'm going to give you 1.5 the amount that I gave you. Allah is still the Tsar of the Yam, said, Rabbi Shalom, that's the world. Yes, Shemit Shetavetz Rabbi, is there a servant that's going to, you know, I'm never going to get this. I'm going to come to you. Oh, whenever you want, you can come to my house. I'm going to go and ask you. Well, I'm not going to ask you. A servant's going to come and ask me. Somebody says, don't worry. Not like Kishin Heliar. Hashem said, the Kishin rib will be for me as a guarantor that I'll pay you back for the Egyptians that I took back from you. Mayad pulled us in the bush. Immediately the sea spit back the Egyptians onto dry land. And the Jews came and they saw the mission. Like said, Mayar Yisrael Mitzrayim Mesos Vazim. The Jews saw the Egyptians dead on the edge of the sea, and that's when they sang Az Yashan. Now says Gemara, Echad Mefzer. What's this 1.5 amount? Because the Ilu Parak said by the power of the Egyptians, it says Sheish Mesos Echad Bachar. There were 600 chosen chariots. The Ilu Besisrik said by Sisra, and it says in Sheiftim, Teshem Mesos Echad Bachar. There were 900 iron chariots. Which, as the Gemara says, what was the story that happened? Which the fish said, because they got back what they were supposed to get from by the Egyptian. Kiyasa Sisra and Sisra came, Asalayu, Bedaka de Parzla. So Sisra and his army came upon the Jewish people with iron spears. So what they didn't realize about it being as a conduit for heat. So God brought out the stars from their orbit. So he says, the Pasuk in Shaykhim, Shemayim Milchim, from the heavens they fought against Sisra, which were HaKechav and the stars. Now, Kibin and Chizuk Kech Vashem Amalai, once the stars were shining down on them, Akadira Hanid the Kedakri the Parzal, so the iron spears started getting hot. So the Chizu Lakru LaMiskan Avshay Ben Al Kishon, they went down to go take a cool themselves off in the Kishon River, you know, take a break from all this war fighting over here, just cool down in the river. Amalakash Boch and Al Kishon, the God said to Al Kishon, Lech Vahashim Avayim, so go pay up your guarantee, which we have to give back to the sea, all these enemies of the Jewish people. Me'ad Ger from Nachal Kishon. So this big tidal wave comes, the Nachal Kishon swallowed them up, Mishlich Liyam, and threw them into the sea, like it says in the Pasuk Kelis, Kol Nachalim Hocham Aliyam. All the streams go to the sea. You brought them out to sea, like it says in the Pasuk, Nachal Kishon Garfam, the Kishon River. That it swallowed them up. Nachal Kedumim, it's the early river. What does it mean, the early river? It's Nachal Nasa Ar Mikedem. It's a river that had been a guarantor Mikedem from earlier times, which was at the times of the Kriyas Yamsef, Nachal Kishon was had to pay back the debt owed to the fish. Ah, but he says, at that moment when the fish got 1.5 on their money, the fish of the sea opened up, and they said, and the truth of Hashem is eternal, when he paid us back the gift from the army of Paroi to get sustenance from. Now, continue on this idea about Howl, some of the Pesukim in Howl. So, Amr B'Shem Malachi says, my dear, so what does it mean? He transforms the barren wife. What does this mean? Amr Knesset is open like a the Knesset Yisrael, which actually Rashbam explains, needs to say the elders and the distinguished ones of the generation, they say, for the fact that they're not so respected, they're disrespected. Like it says, Im Habonim, the mother of the children, which they scream on the children because they made them Akeres Habayis. What does that mean? So they say, Lefnei Kadosh Baruch Hu, Lefnei Kadosh Baruch Hu, Bunch of Master the Lord, Samuni Banecha, your sons made me, meaning because of all their sins in Gullahs, Kachul Bezu, like this weasel, Hadar Bekri Batim, that dwells in the foundations of the houses. So that's Akeres Habayis, is Ikri Habatim, meaning that's like in Gullahs, I'm like on the bottom, I'm in the foundation, like a weasel, that's how I am because of your children, the Jewish people sins. Now, Dersh Rabbah, continue on expounding the Pesukim in Howl. Magnus said, what does it mean in Pasuk in Howl? Ahavti Kiyishm Hashem, I love him because Hashem hears me. So I'm going to say, Israel, the Jewish people say, a bunch of masterful. Amos Aniyahu Belevanacha, when am I beloved in front of you? Which Rashbam explains. Ahavti means like Ahavtani, like you love me. When do I know you love me? When you hear my voice of supplication, that's when I know I'm beloved by you. Now it says over there in Hal with the Dalisi, I'm poor, and to me is salvation. What does that mean? I'm looking at this to look at both of the Jewish people in the Hashem, a bunch of master world. Alpha Pisha Dala Niba Mitzvah, although I'm poor in mitzvahs, Lacha Ani, but for you I am, Valina Lashia, and therefore to me it's appropriate to be saved more than all the nations because the Jewish people, they designate you as the one, as their God. And therefore, I'm fit to be saved, even though I'm poor mitzvahs. Now, Amrav Kahana, because Shachali B'Shmo B'Bisi, when B'Shmo B'Bisi became ill, Shalchai Rebbe sent him, you know, you're getting ill, you might be passing on, send us two or three things that you said over from your father, which Rashbam actually points out, many times in Shas we find that Rebbe sent B'Shmo B'Bisi when he was sick, and the things he responded to him are not the same as it says somewhere else. So either he says that maybe B'Shmo became sick many times, and every single time Rebbe sent him and he responded. Or actually, no. It was only one time that he responded, but the Gemara, the Shas, put it in the Masechtas, each one in his appropriate place. Read that as a Neshalta, he sent him Kachama Abba. This is what my father said, and that's why our Gemara is bringing it over here, because it relates to that of Halal. Ma'idah Siv, what does it mean in the Pasuk, Halalus Hashem Kol Goyim, praise Hashem all the nations? The question is, Umasa Oilu Ma'ayav Adetayim, what are the nations of the world, what are they doing over here to praise God? Because Aleinu Gaba Chazdai, because Hashem does kindness to us, they have to praise God. So in the Hachim, this is what it means. Halos Hashem Kogayim, praise Hashem all the nations, Agvurz in the Flays Dov, Badayu, regarding all the might and the wonders that he does for them. When they see in the world, they also see. Now, Kol Shekinon, the reason why he's saying it is there, to show us the Jewish people, the Gavar Aleinu Chazdai, where his kindness overpowers us more than all the nations and all the different cultures, for sure we should say an unbelievable Halof Hashem. Boyd had another teaching, he said, was Asid Mitzrayim. Ultimately, the Egyptians are going to Shetobi Dermal Mashiach, they're going to bring a gift to Mashiach. Now, the Egyptians are going to think that we're not going to receive the gift from them. Hashem is going to tell Mashiach, Kibul Mehem, accept the gift from the Egyptians. You know why? They were good hosts, they were hosts for my children in Mitzrayim. So, even though you might not have been the best, they might not have been the best hosts, but they hosted the Jewish people, and therefore you should accept the gift. So miyad, like the pasuk says in Tehillim, Yesoyu Chashman in Mitzrayim, they're going to bring all these gifts to Melech HaMashiach, to Yerushalayim, like it says over there before, Mehichalecha Yerushalayim, L'chol Yivil Melech HaMashiach, all the kings and the Egyptians are going to bring these gifts to the Melech HaMashiach. Now, Nasa Kush, Kavachem Basim, now Kush, Ethiopia, they're going to make a Kavachem by themselves. They can say, Umaha, Ulashun Eshtab Duben Kach, if the Egyptians, which enslaved the Jewish people, they're accepting gifts from them, so me, the Ethiopian, we didn't enslave them. Loi Koshkin, isn't it for sure? So Hashem says to Mashiach, yeah, except from them. Miyad, right away, it says over there until Kush, Torah, Yodim, Lelehem. So the Ethiopians, they come running with their hands to God. So Nasa Malchus, Rimi, Rishol, Kabuchamas. Now the wicked kingdom of Rome, they make a Kabuchamra and they say, wait. If these cultures, these people are not even brothers, they're not related to the Jewish people, and they're still there except for them, we were brothers, Esav, which is where Rome comes from. We're brothers of Yaakov, like Koshkin is all the more so. Allah says to Gabriel, no. The Pasuk says over there, Ga'ar rebuke Chayes Kana, the beast of the Kana. So what does it mean? A few different interpretations. Ga'ar Chaya, rebuke the wild animal, which refers to the wicked kingdom of Rome, but and acquire for yourself the assembly, meaning that of the Jewish people. So we reject that of Rome. Or the Bach, another interpretation is, it's part of that part of the pasuk. Rebuke the wild animal of the reeds, meaning Shadar Benakam, which dwells amongst the reeds. What is it, where does it see it dwells amongst the reeds? I feel like it's the pasuk in Tehillim. It says, Yichar Semeno, Chazir miyar, and the boar, the chazir, the of the forest, he ravages. Vizis saw the yirena, and the crawler of my field, he's going to graze. Now that actually refers to Edom, because the pasuk in Daniel, when it talks about the different four kingdoms, it has them all as an image of an animal. And when it comes to Edom, it talks about the way of a chazir. So we see that this pasuk is referring to a chazir. Or a third interpretation, Omer b'chir bar Abba b'chir, it says gar b'chaya. Rebuke the wild animal. Again, these are all referring to Edom, and then we see we reject, we're not taking gifts from them. All their actions are all written with the same quill, with the same pen, meaning they're all one mouth, they're all in unison saying to do bad to the Jewish people. In other words, if the Jewish person comes to educate in front of them, they're all going to hold them liable. And this is from the deacon that says Kana in the singular, not Kana in the plural. It sounds like it's one pen. They're all the same thing. It's always bad for the Jew. Now the pasuk says over there in Tehillim, Adas Abir, the assembly of the mighty, the Egli Amim, with the calves of the nations. What does this mean? This is again going back in Edom as they relate to the Jewish people. Sheshachtu Abir, where Edom slaughters the valiant, the mighty ones, meaning the Jewish people, Ka'agolim She'elam Balam, like calves that don't have owners. That's what it means, the Egli Amim, meaning the calves of the whole world, this Hefka, that have no owners. That's how the non-Jews treat the Jewish people. As the pasuk there continues, Misrapes. The word Misrapis actually has two words, Mater Pas, which means, Mater means to open up, Pas means your palm. And the opening of the hands, Beratze Kesef, with bribes of money, what does this mean? Shepesh Nyalik Amalam, where they open up the hands to receive bribes, but they don't even do the desire of the owners. In other words, they stipulate with the Jews that they'll do as they want for the bribes that they're taking, but they don't even keep their words. They take the money, the Yimach Shemams, and then they don't even do it, then they laugh all the way as they take them on the cattle cars. The pasuk says, "Pizer Amim," which actually the gift is "Bizer Amim," the dispersion of the nations. Kedavos Yechpatzu, they desired closeness. What does this mean? Migram Lam Yisrael Sheispazav Benu Mesa'ilum. What caused that the Jewish people should be dispersed amongst the nations of the world? That's Pizer Amim. That the Jewish people should be dispersed amongst the nations is Kreivish Oichafet in them, because the Jews wanted to be close to them. That's why they are in Galus amongst the nations. Now another teaching, Va'oid Shalachlei Oster B'Shmol. Sent to Rebbe from his father of Yesi, the following teaching. Gimel Meis, Vishishim Echamisha Shlokim. There are 365 marketplaces, but Kraft Galdel Sharemi in the large metropolis of large city of Rome. Now, every single marketplace had 365 towers. And in every single tower, every single one had 365 steps. Chamala Mala, and every single step, they had enough to sustain the whole entire world. However, we understand this. But Amr Reb and the Gersis, Amr Shimon Berebi, the Rebbe, Amr Lassam saying the Gersis, Bishmo Berebis, the Rebbe, to Hani Laman. Who is all this going to? He said, Lacha, Ulachav, Rachel, Lachav, Resach. To you, to your friends, and your friends' friends. Somebody says the Pasuk in Yeshaya. Safra, our merchandise, Vesnan, and our gifts. Kodesh Lashem, Holy Hashem. Lo Yotze will not be stored. Lo Yechasim, it's not going to be treasured. Kiliyoshma Fnei Hashem Yevagemer. Rather, to those who said among Hashem, that's where it's going to go. Says the Imam, Lo Yotze. What does it mean? It's not going to be stored. Rav Yosi says Lo Yotze means the base Yotze. That means the granary where you store your grain, your oil, and your wine. What does it mean? Lo Yechasim, which is a stronger terminology. Chasim is like bechazaka. It's going to be treasured. The Beis Geniza that talks about the treasury of where there's gold and silver, which is hidden and concealed in a safe, that's not going to be for them. Rather, as the Gemara says, my, what does it mean? Kili Yesh Mokne Hashem, it's going to go to those who sit in the Rav Hashem. And Allah says, as we continue to talk about Kofi Tessam and Aleph, Zeha Marka Mokum Chabeb Yeshiva, this refers to someone who knows where his friend sits in Yeshiva, that he knows to say, oh, that guy sits over there, that guy sits over there. Because since he chaps where everyone sits, obviously he's always there and he knows where everyone sits. So he's the Yom, the Yesh Mokne Hashem, he gets all his treasures. Ikadamina, those that say, Omer Balazai says, Zahma Kamapani Chabeb Yeshiva. It refers to someone who greets his friend when he comes to Yeshiva. That's the Yeshua Hashem. He's the one who merits all these things. And my, what does it mean over there in the Pasik, the Machasa Atik, to the one who covers the ancient? Zah Machasa Dvarim, this refers to someone who covers over things, Shekisa Atik Yamar, that the one who is the old of days, which refers to Kodesh Bofu, like the Pasik that Neil describes Hashem, but Atik Yamin Yasim, means old of days because he was here before the world was created. That he covers over what Hashem covered over. Mind in the what Hashem covered over that we should cover over. Sister Tyre, the secrets of the Tyre, which is Ma'aser Merkava, the acts of the chariot, which are brought in Tanakh and Yecheskel, Ma'aser Bereishis, the acts of creation, which or the explanation of Hashem's in Shem Havaya, like the pasuk says, no, Zesh Mila Alam. This is my name that should be hidden, and someone covers it over, and he doesn't give it over to just anybody. He's rather worried, as the Gemara says, Chagid Avi Gimelal. He's the one that's doing this honorable thing of Mechasa Atik. Now, actually, those who say the opposite. This is one who reveals the things that the Hashem had covered over. Now, what is that? Actually, refers to what's called Taimei Torah, the reasonings of the Torah. Meaning, originally, they were covered, and Hashem revealed them, and He gave permission to them to be revealed. And whoever reveals them, he merits to what it says here in this pasuk. Some of the discussions in Daf, and Psaf and Daf, Kofi Tres, was we spoke about the fourth cup of wine by the Seder night that we have Hal, and we said that we say the Birchas Hashir. What is Birchas Hashir? Either it's what we say after every Hal, which is Aluch Hashem Akeinu, which we, and Baruch Hashem Megil Machmo Batash Bachas, or, and also, it means Nishmas, which is what we say. Additionally, we say Hal HaGadol, which is, why is it considered Hal HaGadol? Because we say, Nesh Lechem Chol Basuk, Yilam Chaz Hashem, you give to everybody, that's unbelievable. Three different opinions, what is Hal HaGadol? Either Kuflam Advav, another Kuflam Hei, or from Kuflam Adalad. And some wanted to say, actually, no, you say Hashem Rai, because Lo Yechsa, that's going on, people say that by every Suda, to thank Hashem for what they ate at the meal earlier in the Seder. In the Halagadol, this 26 Haidus, because it refers to the generation that Hashem sustained with His kindness to the world without Taira. And why do we say Hashem Ki Tov Kilam Chazai? Because Hashem collects from His goodness. So that's Kilam Chazai. What's the Chazai to the Olam? That Ki Tov, He's collecting from the good that He gave you. And that's great because now he doesn't have to collect from your body, rather he can collect from your finances. We said how difficult a person's panasim is, initial adam is. We had many different teachings from Elizabeth Azariah. We said the hal that we say, why do we say the regular hal, not hal agadol? Because it has five things, which are Yitzis Mitzrayim, Kriyas Yamsim, Teretz, Kriyas Amesim, Chavash Mashiach, or because we said it talks about the saving of the righteous souls from Gehenna, or because it talks about the saving of the righteous in Chanan Meshav Azariah, which we spoke about the story that Nimrod wanted to kill Avraham Avinu, and Hashem saved him, and Gabriel, who wanted to save him, he was paid back. But that was for the later on, Emes Hashem Lo'ilam, which we said either Hanam Hashem Azari said Emes Hashem Lo'ilam, or Gabriel said Hashem Lo'ilam when he was able to save his grandchildren, or it's actually with the dog of Shabayam, but they said Emes Hashem Lo'ilam later on by Sisera, because they got 1/2 on their money from that of the Rechve Apar. We said in the future the nations are going to make gifts to Mashiach and they're going to accept from them all, but they're not going to accept from Edom because, like the pasuk says, Gar Chayes Kana, because they're not worthy because of how they treated the Jewish people. And we says, who all the money of Rome, where is it going to go? Kili Yesh Mufin Hashem, who is that? Either someone who knows where everyone sits in the Beis Medrash, or he greets everyone who comes to Yeshiva. And we said, it's also someone who's Mechasa Atik, which either means to say that he keeps hidden the secrets of Torah, or he reveals those time retire, which are supposed to be. Thank you to any time for hosting.